The title of my presentation is ETSUDO.PL, Towards Polish Oceanographic Data Committee. This acronym stands for the project providing distributed oceanographic data center and virtual center providing data to users. I am representing a group of authors coming from the institutions building consortium of the project. The consortium consists of two groups of institutions. One group is consisting Polmar Consortium, Maritime Institute in Gdańsk, Polish Geological Institute, National Research Institute, Sea Fisheries Institute, National Research Institute, and the other group compound Sub-Baltic system, and this system is operating now. I will tell a bit more later on. And this group consists of Institute of Oceanology, which is leader of the consortium, and University of Gdańsk, Pomeranian Academy in Słupsk, and University of Szczecin. These institutions are scientific organizations, and they are complementary referring to oceanography domain, so they are not overlapping. Each institution has unique competences and unique area of activity. Three institutions, Maritime Institute in Gdańsk, Sea Fisheries Institute and Institute of Oceanology, have occasion to build infrastructure for oceanographic data center in years 2012-2014. Maritime Institute in Gdańsk has deployed this infrastructure in 2014 and now is providing data using online database. It's more than 50 terabytes of data, mostly data coming from models, but have also 150 registered users. And of course, when system develop in time, the more and more problems of IT are showing. The data managed by Maritime Institute in Gdańsk, the data are EcoSounder profiles, side scan scanner profiles, sub-bottom profiler, magnetometer data, and oceanographic model data, which is available for free. The next institution is Polish Geological Institute, and this institute also provide data for ImodNet geology and is partner for GeoSeas. It's a complementary project for CDataNet, so the standards developed by this institute or standard deployed by this institute are compatible with CDataNet dictionaries and ISO 19115. This institute holds national geological archives and is developing central geological database. Institute of Oceanology has also occasion in 2012 to deploy infrastructure for oceanographic data center. The data, now is the time when we are upgrading the system, so we are extending possibilities of storage, more than 1,000, more than 1 petabyte, more than 1,000 terabytes. Of course, we are extending these possibilities because we expect more data in the future, and we are doing replica of the data to scientific cloud provided by Tri-City Academic Computer Center. Institute of Oceanology also was leader of consortium developing Sub-Baltic system. This system combines in situ data and remote sensing data with modeled data. This is very important because having remote sensing data, we do not have, we very often have gaps, and we have to fill the gaps with data coming from model. Sub-Baltic provide current status of the environment and short-term forecast data. The system is complementary to Copernicus service because Copernicus is of course is widely used by community, has long time support by European Commission and covers all European marine waters, but Sub-Baltic is much more extended, referring number of parameters. It's up to 170 parameters and is merging satellite data and modeling products for everyday forecast. This is an example of Sub-Baltic product portal. You can find this on the web page. And what is the most significant, the something which could be interesting very much is wave forecast coming from model provided by University of Gdańsk. Sea Fisheries Institute is covering activities about living resources of Polish economical exclusive zone and has a lot of data and provide monitoring and service for living resources data. And also was developing infrastructure for oceanographic data center. So if we compare competences of different institutions, Sea Fisheries Institute is investigating and providing research, doing research about living resources. Institute of Oceanology is collecting data and providing information about water body, and Maritime Institute in Gdańsk is collecting data for geology and bottom. So, data are waiting to be open. A lot of these resources are available in some way, but there is no unique system which can guide a user, potential user of the data to one place. So we have decided in front of lack of policy at national level, we have decided as consortium of institutions to develop a system from the scratch. The system aggregating all data we have at our resources and providing unified information to potential users. We have to solve some obstacles, especially audit of legal agreements for projects, because some of data comes not from scientific projects, but from commercial contracts, and this data has to be investigated if could be open. And we also need very huge labor effort to provide metadata, to discover metadata for these collections, and to provide technological level infrastructure for storage and dissipation of information. There are a few basic assumptions we have decided to get when we want to develop system. First of all, we are using open software and open systems because it's easier to maintain the system in the future. We have decided to stay with the systems we have already developed, because these systems provide infrastructure. So we are building another layer on federated systems we have already developed. And the other basis, other principle, is that users can access the system via any device. So the system has to be platform independent. And this is general chart providing concept of the system. In the central part, we have this broker. We call it EdSudo. And we have, also clients on the left side, and system federated system on the right side. And this chart provides concept of the system itself. The central part, the biggest orange the orange box is a central system providing a single sign on for users and providing metadata discovery, providing linked data, because we want to create fifth level on five star model open data. And going to conclusions, deployment of unified system providing access to data resources managed by key scientific organizations in Poland can trigger an added value for national economy. Administration and commercial companies are free to use data and also are welcome to ask for defined products. Unified data formats and protocols will boost development of the services. So if we provide data, provide application programming interfaces and provide this data for free, this will speed up development of applications. System is open for all stakeholders, so administration, commercial companies are ready to aggregate data, and we can also host data coming from other projects, commercial, scientific, and administrative projects. For instance, we have agreement with maritime authorities developing a spatial information system. We also cooperate with Institute of Meteorology and Water Management because they are national, they are providing national monitoring service. So this project, when finished, is intended to be well integrated with CData Cloud, because we want to deploy CData Cloud standards and ImodeNet systems, and further integration of operations of infrastructural and organizational level will provide solid basis for Polish Oceanographic Data Committee. Thank you.